My name's Dan May. I'm the co-founder of a company called Painting Practice. We're a digital design company helping bridge the gap between traditional art department and visual effects. I'm really kind of, I suppose, expanded and grown in the last 5 years with productions like His Dark Materials. Unreal Engine came in early in pre-production, and we dabbled a little bit in real-time rendering on a couple of other shows. For Black Mirror, we built the San Junipero nightclub in a game engine to sort of show Charlie Brooker how to like navigate around. So I was familiar with the technology, and then we started doing previs and set design using the engine, primarily for the major set of Trollesund and also the Bear Palace stuff. Unreal was a great way of getting people to physically be in a space that was not even conceived. We'd done a concept model, and we basically scanned the quarry with photogrammetry, the drones, built a high-res model, dropped in all the concept models, started applying Unreal textures on them, and then we were able to show the director, producers, like, this is what our town could be.
The scale of this show gave us an opportunity to push the exploration a little bit. And so, yes, with Trollesund, we got to explore for real, and we got to really make some key decisions on the scale of the buildings and the scale of the set, because these are very expensive sets. And on a show like His Dark Materials, where you're building an entire town for one episode, you've got to make really good decisions that are practical and financial and creative, and they're all combined. And that tool and what Painting Practice's team created gave us an ability to make critical judgments that meant that we could get it right on the edge of affordable and absolutely on the edge of shootable, in the sense of there was no fat on what we built.
The bear fight from season one on this, you know, something that physically doesn't exist. We didn't even have the set at that point. One of the things I found the most useful was giving me a virtual camera to be able to get in that scene and shoot the shots that I wanted and walk around and look at the bear fight and see, you know, because I wanted that fight to feel like it was a real fight being shot, not a CG fight. I could actually do that with Unreal. I could move around that room physically, get the camera in the position I wanted to, and see on screen on my camera monitor what was going on, and record those shots and cut it together. And that was really freeing for a director. It almost reminded me when I used to make like short films and stuff like that, and I was learning to make films. I used to go out with a camera and just go out and film stuff and try things out. You just want to be creative with a bunch of people and just like find the essence of what the story's about. And I didn't really think that previs would help me do that side of things. I thought it might help me with technically where to put a camera and stuff like that, but it didn't. It actually made me go, right, I don't need to worry about any of the noise. I can actually just go and create something.
I'm now really excited by the next 10 years because of this Unreal thing, in terms of it will just almost be start to finish. Maybe all production will end up like that.